In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Morning.
We celebrate today with the whole Church the feast day of St. Ignatius of Antioch, Bishop and Martyr of the Roman Church. We ask for his prayers today that we, this day, may follow in the footsteps of the apostles. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting
life. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty Heavenly God, and all the sacred body of your Church with the confessions of holy martyrs, grant, we pray, that just as the glorious passion of St. Ignatius of Antioch, which we celebrate today, brought him eternal strength, so it may be for us an end of protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever. Amen.
Amen. Take as your models everybody who is already doing this, and study them as you used to study us. I have told you often, and I repeat it today with tears, there are many who are behaving as the enemies of the cross of Christ. They are destined to be lost. They make fools into their God, and they are proudest of something they ought to think shameful. The things they think important are earthly things. For us, our homeland is in heaven. And from heaven comes the Saviour we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will transfigure these wretched bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. He will do that by the same power with which he can subdue the whole universe. So then, my brothers and dear friends, do not give way, but remain faithful to the Lord. I miss you very much, dear friends. You are my joy and my crown. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From all my terrors, the Lord set me free.
All my terrors,
the Lord set me free. I will bless the Lord at all times, his praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, the humble shall hear and be glad.
All my terrors,
the Lord set me free. Glorify the Lord with me, together let us praise his name. I sought the Lord and he answered me. From all my terrors, he set me free. From all my terrors, he set me free, Lord. Lord, look towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This poor man called, the Lord heard him and rescued him from all his distress. From all my terrors, the Lord set me free. The angel of the Lord is encamped around those who revere him, to rescue them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He is happy who seeks refuge in him. From all my terrors, the Lord set me free. Alleluia, alleluia. Happy the man who stands firm when trials come, for he has proved himself and will win the crown of life. Alleluia.
Jesus said to his disciples,
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Saint Ignatius of Antioch, who we remember today in our Mass, was part of that small group of people who were the first successors to the apostles of the Lord. As the church began to grow older, yet still very, very young, people like St. Ignatius and his brothers and sisters would have been part of a very small church community. Yet St. Ignatius left us some letters which have some beautiful insights into the life of the early church. Their steadfastness, especially in the light of the persecution that they were experiencing by the Roman Empire. St. Ignatius himself would die in Rome at the Forum, after many months of suffering and pain. And yet, even during those times, he managed to communicate to the early church, forever encouraging them to be steadfast in the Lord and to have hope always in God's love. Saint Ignatius, pray for us.
So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers of intercession this day. Let us pray for the church. Let us pray especially for the church still persecuted in this day and age, that those who are faithful to God's word will be redeemed. Lord, in your hands,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our world and its many needs. We pray for those parts of our world which are suffering from famine, from war, from conflict. We pray that the world may give generously in their time of need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may be like the saints forever and for the coming world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick and lying in God. We pray especially for those who suffer alone, that they may find the support that they need. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur this time, the families who grieve and mourn, that they may be comforted. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of the Apostles, Queen of the Saints, we pray to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We make the answer to all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given to your hands and made, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept.
just as you accepted Saint Ignatius the meat of Christ, made pure bread through his martyrdom and passion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is true, right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised, their very sufferings are the wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardour to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours. Therefore all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all hosts of angels, cry out and without end, we acclaim.
Holy,
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 holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy blessings, gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered unto one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Ignatius of Antioch, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, who dare to say, by the hand of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Love God.
You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Love God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Love God. You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I pray for you,
that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.